Shane, I'm not sure if you're still back there, but if you are, I need to talk to you. Please come down to the ring. Shane, what were you thinking?
Things obviously got a little out of control.
Do you remember, it was about a year ago, The Miz went on Talking Smack and he berated me and he tore into me about how I would never wrestle again. It was shortly after I retired. And every week he kept pushing it and pushing it and pushing it. And do you know how many times I thought, you know what, screw WWE, screw this job, I'm gonna headbutt this jerk right in the face. But I didn't, because you told me, as the general manager of SmackDown Live, I had to put the WWE first, I had to put the fans first, and I had to put our employees first. So every week, I restrained myself. I kept myself from punching him right in the face. And I did what was best for this company and for this show. Shane, you can't assault our employees or our superstars. We can't run SmackDown Live like that.
You're right, and I know I put you in a tough spot, and I take full responsibility for my actions. I should not have put my hands on Kevin Owens. But you have to understand this. When someone talks about my family like that, I go into a blind rage. And when they cross that line, there is no coming back. You yourself, Daniel, are now a father. Imagine if the shoe was on the other foot.
Don't throw that in my face. You don't understand. Do you know the problems that we're in legally right now? Not just you, the entire WWE. Kevin Owens is a vindictive man. He is going to sue every member of your family. Not that I care about that, but I care about the jobs of the people in the back. That's how they feed their families.
I do too. I will take care of this. I will talk to Kevin Owens and I will smooth this over.
I'm afraid, Shane, it's too late for that. I got a call just before I came out here. It was from your father. Shane, effective immediately, per the chairman of the board and the CEO of the WWE, I'm sorry, man. You're indefinitely suspended.